We're in a band.
Yeah, we play rock and roll.
Thomas will tell you.
He'll tell you.
He'll tell you.
I played the guitar when I was 5. Picked it up when I was 5. It was always the guitar in the house.
I started singing when I was 2. By the time I was 4, I was the opening acts for the country music people that would come into Oklahoma City.
I started playing the bass about 3 years ago. My brother played the guitar. I decided to just play the bass.
When I first started playing the drums, I was 6. All my brothers are drummers. They taught me.
When you hear the music, they don't play like they're young kids.
Young doesn't make a difference. I mean, you can hear the music. We're not a kid band. We're kids. We're not playing kids music. That's for sure.
I met Steve when I was 8 in Dunton, in England, Monsters of Rock Festival.
I was on tour with David Lee Roth Band, and we were playing Castle Donington, which is a huge festival that the Europeans have. It's based in England. There was about 92,000 people at the show.
I was like backstage, and I was just playing in the back, like the boot of my car, like just strum the guitar. And then this roadie guy walked along, and he just says, "Can you really play that thing?" And says, "Yeah." He walks in the bus and he comes out and says, "Come here, Steve wants to see you."
Comes into my caravan, he brings a little amp, didn't talk a word, he was with his dad, and he just started playing. And the only thing you can do is laugh because it was so, it was a virtuoso. This kid was just wailing, he was 8 years old.
He's gone, he was freaking out and stuff. And he's saying, should make an album. Then I got a record deal with Interscope, and then Steve produced it.
I've always had this vision. What I wanted to do one day is, help make a record or produce a band of young kids.
I wanted them all to be like 13, 14, 15. It took a long time to find them all.
I didn't think that it was possible to find kids this young who could play this well. We totally lucked out, you know.
Steve is great to work with. He's been an idol of mine, you know. Now to work with him, it's just wonderful. I mean, I don't think anybody can do a better job than he's doing.
I gotta tell you something, there are no studio musicians on this record. I did not play one note of guitar on this entire record. It's all the kids.
Don't touch that, you're gonna ruin your guitar solo.
It was great because it wasn't just like, well, this is what you're gonna play. This is what you're gonna do. It's not like that though, because he was totally open-minded.
A lot of times people are trying to tell the kids what to do or what they think they should do or whatever, but they really know what they want to do.
I was looking for a single, but I just listened for lots of records and stuff, and I put Thin Lizzy on 19, we all liked it. It was tried out in the studio. We knew it sounded good, so is this the one? We can do a lot of headbanging in it.
Danny's great, man. He's just out there, you know. He gets down with his bad self.
Thomas, when you first get to know him, he's a shy guy, and then when you get to know him, he's a wild man.
You might get me nervous!
He's a 12-year-old guitar player, but look at him play.
Zach's a cool guy. He's a great bass player. I dig his bass playing.
Brooke says like weird stuff and does weird stuff.
There's a certain reckless abandon that I think mature musicians lose, but these kids have an abundance right now. And you can see it.
Get down, get down, get down.
I'm trying to capture that in their playing. and in their music, and it's coming out.
We're a dynamite.
We're going to rehearse for a couple of weeks, and we're going to go on tour. We're going to go on tour.
And I want a tour bus with a goat on the side of it painted with Steve's left ear.
I think we get to have like a garage party everywhere we go.
I'm looking forward to go on tour because I like rocking the stage. You know what I mean?
You really haven't seen like a young heavy metal band or hard rock band out there. Not really musicians, you know, four people. I mean, that was cool about the album. It's just four people playing.
The real magic is the stuff that comes out your fingers. The energy what comes out of your fingers. Do you feel that, Mr. Camera?